What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Angry Porto, aka Take It Slow, aka Clancy, aka that's too many nicknames. Fuck, man. Back again with another episode of Fallout 2 20th Anniversary Playthrough. And where we left off, we had just wrapped up some quests with the Mordinos and the Salvators. We did our boxing quests. We did a few small missions in the Shark Club. That's not quite resolved yet, but that won't be for a little bit. And yeah, we're gonna go head over to the right section in a moment. I'm just going to head to Eldridge over here at New Anor Arms real quick. Do some hand in a little quest I got for him. Excuse me, I'm really gassy right now. I'm out of burping and talking. All right, hello friend. What can I do for you? I got that laser pistol that I promised. Well, hell then. True to my word, here's something for your trouble. Gives you me a bunch of caps. Takes a pistol. Damn, strange looking thing, isn't it? I want something else. Alright. Yeah, just a quick little easy quest right there. Alright, let's go. Oh, wow, a bunch of people leveled up. Alright, we're going to go to the right side of town. Get it? Get it? Right, the right side. Is the right. I kill me. All right, let's level up first. Okay, okay. Here is when level 15, when we start to get our bonus stuff. And that is not what, and I accidentally selected one. Okay, let's not do that. Yeah, we get our, this is when we get the bonus rate of fire, bonus hand-to-hand attacks. These come quite a bit in handy later in the game, or not even later in the game, right now in the game. I think I'm going to go with the rate of fire. I'm going to be slowly building up into my sniper build. Although I'm going to end up getting both, but for where I'm about to go, I'm going to want bonus rate of fire. Okay, let's see here. Let's bump up my lockpick. Always like getting that up. Science and repair. Okay. Outdoorsman. Let's bump that up. I'm gonna bank 4. I don't quite know where I want to put it. Science and repair become pretty. There's a few big skill blocks later in the game. One for science and one for repair. So I want to make sure those are up to par. But Vic and Myron, respectively, should be able to break those skill blocks for me, but I like to make sure. Okay. And this is actually a really fortuitous level, because when we go to CRA Armor Depot, I like to not bring my companions, just because they end up taking a lot of damage there for no reason, or get killed by the turrets out front, so we're probably going to leave them in the Reno, but we get a lot of EXP at the CRA Armor Depot, so it's kind of like... if I don't bring them, then I risk them not leveling up with me, but... Alright, enough about that. Let's talk to this guy. Yeah, who are you? I'm Chris. Chris Wright. Family Wright. Glad you asked. I'm looking for a job. Family Wright hiring? Well, I mean, the Wright family, my family, might have an opening. I ain't promising nothing, but go to the mansion south of here. Find my brother Keith and tell him I sent you. Name's Chris. Chris Wright. Thanks. Alright. So, we just got our inn with the Wright family. Alright, does anyone have any pistols hanging around? 10mm? 10mm? There we go. Ask and ye shall receive, right? Alright. If you remember, I said earlier that Salvatore's last mission can actually be acquired elsewhere. If you talk to these kids, they can give it to you. We're not at all ready to go do it, because it involves an encounter with the Enclave. It doesn't necessarily go hostile, but I like to make it go hostile, so we'll end up doing that quite a bit later. But for now, let's just go do some work for the Wrights. The Wright family. What you want? I don't know you. My dad don't know you, and if you don't start explaining, it ain't gonna matter. Who are you? I'm Keith Wright of Family Wright. Now, you gonna tell me what you're doing here? Chris told me to stop by. I'm looking for work. Can you help me out? Chris sent you, huh? That's right. He said you might have some work for me. Hmm. Knocks on the door. Pah! He sticks his head in. There's some mumbling, and then he comes back and nods at the door. You can go in, but watch out. Dad's in a pissy mood. Thanks. All right. The Wright family is, in my opinion, the most stand-up family in New Reno. I mean, there's still a bunch of mobsters, but they deal mostly in alcohol and less nefarious things in the other family. Wrinkles cover the old man's face. It looks like his expression, is other than a scowl, is foreign to him. Only a few brown hairs left on his thick gray hair. Start talking, tribal. Who are you and what do you want? My name's Porto and interested in a job. No shit. Well, pleased to meet you, Porto. Glad you stopped by. Damn neighborly of you. Looking for work in my family, huh? Yes, I... So happens my family is family, right? Blood thicker than water and all. What makes you think I'd want a tribal trash like you in my family? I got all the hitmen I need. Give me a test. Let me prove myself. Studies you for a moment. All right. Maybe you not being in the family could be a good thing. You got children? Not to my knowledge. One of my sons, my boy, Richard, passed away recently. Drug overdose. Jet. How can I help? I want to know what dealer gave that shit to Richard and forced him to take it. Every time I send my boys to find out, they turn up nothing. Maybe somebody who ain't got right blood could get some answers. Forced him to take it? Face turns red. My boys are clean, and they know to stay away from that shit, or I'll kill them. Then suddenly, Richie ODs. Someone pumped a tut of jet in him. So much fume was running out of his nose. I'll take the job. If you go this route, he gets pissed at you, so I'm not going to do that. All right, then. Now look, you find that son of a bitch who killed my boy, don't you touch him. Just come back and tell me the dead man's name. I'll take care of it from there. Any leads? No. Everybody's too scared to talk. To a right, anyway. If I were you, I'd question some of the Reno drug pushers, see what they know. That jet came from somewhere. Any pushers you suspect? Well, yeah, see, it was probably more Dino pusher. That goddamn family controls nearly all the jet in Reno. I'd scope out the Desperado, see what dealers hang out there. Find the person who gave him the jet, don't hurt him, and come back and tell you. Got it. Okay. So, this is, with a high speech skill, it's not too elaborate. But the first time I did this, I didn't talk to Keith Wright again, which you have to do because you need permission to search Richard's room. Can you tell me about your brother Richard? Good kid. Damn, if we ever find out who done it to him. Any ideas who might have done it? A lot of other families sell. Jet could have been any one of them. Mordino's got the most jet. Me, I'm betting is one of them. Can you tell me a little about Richard? Quiet kid. Clean. Kept out of trouble. And for a right, that's something. We buried him in the Golgotha Plains a while ago, but even so, Mom still don't want his room disturbed. It's hard for her to let go, you know? Which room was his? Do you think your mother would mind if I poked around in there? His room? It's the empty one next to Mom's room, the second one down by the kitchen. As for looking around, well, look, don't stay too long and don't mess the place up or Mom will pop a clip she finds out. Thanks, Keith. I won't be long. All right. We gotta go search his room. This was Richard's old room. What do we find? Hey, I found an empty jet canister in here. An empty jet canister. Look at that. How convenient. All right. Let us go. Let's go with the empty jet canister. All right. So, I'm not sure if anyone else can figure it out, but the way I do it is I bring the empty jet canister to this guy right here, Jagged Jimmy J. The man has a slight facial tick and a scar down one of his cheeks. The scar looks like a knife wound. Brother, I had my eye on you since you walked down the street. You know what I see? What do you see? I see a pilot. I see someone who wants to fly. You just need a little help, little jet. Jet, huh? I had some questions. And my pilot friend, when it comes to jet, Jagged Jimmy J's, yo, man. I got the best shit in New Reno. Pure jet, straight jet, safest jet. Jagged Jimmy J, huh? Say, I had some questions. Other dealers, they don't care about quality. But me, I like keeping my customer base and keeping them happy. Know what I'm saying? It's just my way, the Jimmy J way. Hey, the Jimmy J way sounds great and all. That's why I had some questions. So what do you say? What can Jagged Jimmy J do for you today? Damn. Let's see. Where'd you get that scar, Jimmy? Hey, you look familiar to Jimmy. Do I know you, my pilot friend? I've fought in the boxing ring. That's it. I knew I'd see you somewhere before. Damn, why didn't you put from the start? Put Jimmy in his place. Hell, what can I do for you? I want to ask you something. You said before your jet was the safest. There isn't any bad jet floating around, is there? Hell, all I'm saying is Jimmy likes his buyers happy and alive. Draw your own conclusions, my pilot friend. Is breathing more important to you than shoving a few chips off your next jet purchase? Know anything about this jet canister? Takes canister, studies it. Now I... Yeah, this jet's got rad scorp juice in it. Whoever was sucking on this ain't long for this world. Holds canister back. It's poisoned? Hell yes, gotta be careful in this town with shit like that being passed around. That's why Jimmy Jagged Jimmy J always says. Any idea where this might have come from? Now, I don't look. Don't give me spreading the word. That's mine if I were you. I'd ask Jules Renneska about it, but you didn't hear that from me, alright? Rent a school in Jules, huh? I'll ask him about it. Thanks for the tip. Alright. So, yeah, we've discovered that the jet canister that Richard Wright overdosed on was poisoned. Motherfucker. Who could have done that? It was Renneska. Okay. Alright, Renneska, cough it up. Well, out with it already. How are the glasses? Folds arms, adequate. If you're expecting some handout for being a good Samaritan, you're gravely mistaken. Now, what do you want? I had some other questions. Did you sell Jet to Richard Wright? Don't even try to pin that accusation on me. You want to know who did it? Ask Tweedledum and Tweedledum if they're still selling Jet laced with arsenic. Can you tell me anything about this empty jet canister? It's empty. It's a jet canister like the hundreds of others all over New Reno. Anything else I can help you out with? Know anything about the rad scorpion venom traces that are in this canister? Rad scorpion? Renneska suddenly freezes as if remembering something. You know something about it, don't you? Whoa, now just a minute. Don't mess with me, Renneska. You try and weasel out of this one, you'll be joining Richard, understand? Wait a minute. Look, I didn't sell it to the kid. He never bought anything from me. I was asked to make some jet laced with rad scorpion venom, but I didn't sell it to the kid. You were asked to make poison jet for who? The Salvators requested it. They said it was a special order. I didn't know they were going to give it to Wright kid. You had to believe me. I don't poison kids. Just adults, huh, Renneska? You sorry son of a bitch. Let's see. Why did you poison the jet? You had to know they were going to kill someone with it. The Salvators own me. They own this place. And when they want something, I give it to them or they'll kill me and have me replaced. I never meant any harm to that boy. Okay. Yeah, I'm sure you had the best intentions while you were spiking that jet with poison. Goodbye, Renneska. Alright. So, we've exposed Renneska's involvement in Richard Wright's death. Fucking Salvators, man. Fucking Salvators. Alright, we are back at the Wrights. Let's expose this conspiracy. You again? You find out who killed my boy? Your son didn't die of an overdose. He was poisoned. What? Poison? The hell are you talking about? I found this canister that Richard used, was used on Richard. There were traces of rat scorpion venom in the cartridge.
Assuming I believe this for a second, and I ain't saying I am, then who poisoned my son? And why'd they go to the trouble of dosing him with Jet?
Word is it was the Salvators. They pumped him with Jet laced with rat scorpion venom, then left him for you to find.
Now why in the hell would they do that?
Way I see it, the Mordinos control the Jet in Reno. Naturally, you'd blame them for a drug overdose, and then there'd be war. If you two didn't wipe each other out, you'd at least be weakened by the fight. That makes life easier for the Salvators. All they have to worry about then is the Bishops. Stares at you for a moment, a long moment, then a dry chuckle escapes his lips.
You give me an answer and I can't do nothing about it. Them, the Salvators? God damn it.
What's wrong? You know what those Salvator bastards are armed with, friend? Damn Lightbringers. One Salvator packing that kind of heat can kill my whole family without batting an eye. To beat that, I'd need... Don't worry about it. I've kicked the shins out from underneath the Salvators already.
Ha! The ones in Reno, maybe. But you gotta learn about the families. There's still Salvators kicking around beyond Reno. And even if there's just one left, that's trouble. To beat them, I'd need...
What?
Well, now, before I get into specifics, let's settle accounts first. Here's a little cash for your trouble. Plus some ammo, liquor from my private stock, and another job for you if you're interested.
Oh, I'm interested.
It so happens, not long ago, I came across a map that shows an old army base in the mountains not far from here. You find a way in, and I'll see that you're taken care of.
Alright. I'll go check it out. Actually, you know what? Why should I go? Didn't you send somebody already?
Mr. Wright's expression tightens for a moment, then he snorts. Heh, not exactly. The fellows I got the map from are all dead. They were a tough bunch, but they all got wiped out trying to get inside.
They didn't even get inside?
Yeah, the only survivor said, shortly before his unfortunate death,
they killed him, by the way. The Wrights killed this guy.
There's some kind of super gun turrets guarding the entrance. Wiped out most of his boys.
What happened to the survival?
Old Sam Pritchard, sad story. Got drunk one night, mentioned to my boy Keith that he found the base. And before you know it, he draws up a map and dies. He's sleeping in Golgotha now. Seems like Reno's filled with sad stories like these nowadays. I'll take the job. All right, then. Come back when you found a way in, and I'll see you're well rewarded. Now, as for the location of the base, head north, then. He gives you the coordinates of the army base. All right, I'll go check it out. When I find a way inside, I'll be back. All right. So, we have correctly identified who killed Richard Wright and the motive, and we now have the location of the Sierra Army Depot, which is going to give us a pretty big gear spike if we can get inside and go through all the things to do the stuff. There it is. All right, I'm going to head back to my car real quick. Yeah, we're gonna liquidate some shit. I really don't need a lot of the things I'm carrying because where we're going, we don't need. Wait, what's that? What's that quote? Where we're going, we don't need roads.
Where we're going, we don't need roads.
Ah, man, I'm stupid. Yeah, you are. Okay, shut up. Okay. All right, we're gonna go stop at Eldridge's real quick in the basement. Because, well, you'll see. He's got a bunch of shit in the basement that we can steal, and that will come in quite a bit in handy later. There's lockpicks down there. I'm spoiling everything. I'm spoiling it all. Okay. All right, I believe we can just punch this door down. Nope, I'm wrong. All right, pick it down. Loot it all. I want it all. I want it all. And I want it now. Are these dogs gonna bark? And they're gonna piss Eldridge off. I believe we'll come back and check on them eventually, but not yet. All right, so this is why we haven't been paying for weapon upgrades, because this guy down here in the basement, Algernon, I believe his name is, Flowers of Algernon reference, no doubt, he upgrades all our shit for free. All right, let's just do a little bit of looting. I don't really need anything. Really need anything there. Okay. Oh, by the way, guys, if you're looking for the Easter egg in Fallout 2, here it is. Literally an Easter egg. Right, this little pot right here. Okay. Oh, and we picked up an electronic lockpick in that fridge over there, by the way. I almost didn't mention it. It's so, I'm just so used to it. All right, so look. All right, so down here, we're going to do some upgrading. All right, so this is a little, come on. So much shit. Where's the fucking flamer? There it is.
Alright, you'll forgive me. I'm gonna take just a couple minutes to do some inventory managing. I know, right? Alright, so one of the tricks with Algernon is anytime you have him upgrade something, you want to make sure it that there's no ammo in it, because whenever he upgrades it, it will restock the ammo. So for example, this Power Fist and that Assault Rifle I showed you. Let's see. They were empty. Now fully upgraded, full ammo. And see right here, this flamethrower fuel, I've got 5. Now I got 10. I'm gonna put this here. Oh, I got 5 there. Now I got 10. So it's it's a little bit of a cheat, but I guess it's not even a cheat. I mean, I'm not using an edit or anything. I'm just kind of taking advantage of some oversight or oversight. All right. So now when I upgrade these flamers, comes with 5. It comes with 5 flamethrower fuel that turns into 10. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. Oh no. Oh no, where's Marcus?
What do you want?
Hey, I want you to carry these 60 pounds of flamethrower fuel. Can you do that? Thanks, buddy. Okay. Hey, I got another flamethrower, bro. Right, one more. Okay, so that's how we just turned, I think it was 25 flamethrower fuel into 80.
What do you want?
And then, yeah, we got a bunch more ammo for the assault rifle, for the mega power fist. A little bit of shenanigans, but wing on the wing on the. And now, we're going to change Marcus's weapon preference to range than melee, and I have him attacking the closest person because he's going to be running around with a flamethrower now. He's kind of a pain in the ass with his burst mode. He is very indiscriminate with it. He will burst anyone and anything, but I usually don't run into too many problems with him and the flamethrower. So yeah. So that's all that thing about that. And then, yeah, we still are carrying around a lot of shit. Eldridge later, once we become a main man, he's gonna open up his inventory for us, his special inventory, and that's when we'll be able to liquidate a lot of shit. A lot of shit. All right, let's get some of this stuff back. All right, we're gonna do a bit of inventory management, and then we're gonna head off to the Sierra Army Depot. And I'm, yeah. You'll see. Okie dokie. All right, inventory successfully managed. We are going to head to the Sierra Army Depot now. I'm gonna bring my companions just because of how we're gonna make it fairly deep into the base, and I'm gonna inevitably run out of carry weight space. So yeah, they're not gonna like me because they're gonna take some ambient damage going through force fields and shit. But I need them. They're my traveling trunk. Okie dokie. But actually, what we're gonna do is as we make our way into the base right here, what? We're gonna have them wait because I don't want them to get in the line of fire of some of these turrets.
Well,
what do you want? I'll just stay.
Vic would be kind of useful, but yeah, again, I don't even want to just take the risk. Because these turrets will shred them up. Alright, so yeah, here's the front of the Sierra Armor Depot. As you can see, these people who tried to get in initially, not very successful. Alright, so here's a little cheat for scumming your way into the base without going full steam into these turrets. Right here, these fence posts are actually line of sight blockers. So, literally take a shot, hide. Oh, that's bad. I did not realize that thing could hit me from over there. Okay, so we learn something every day, right? So, that thing actually has got the range to attack me from over there, which is no bueno. Alright, so let's make our way over here. Boom. There we go. Can't do shit. And then, yeah, we just do this. And people are worried about robots taking over, huh? Yeah. Okie dokie. Let's make our way over here. Do the same thing. What? Oh god. Alright, same deal. They can see me around that. That's annoying. That one was even yellow, which means it was technically out of. Alright, what do we got? Right here. Let me guess, that one can see me now. Oh, it can. Ouch. Oh man, this fucking fence is cock-blocking me. All right there. Okay. Took a lot of damage right there. But that's the name of the game. It's a risky business. Oops, lenses are broken. Cool. I'm actually going to take a super stim pack. Because I am fucked up. Let's loot some dead bodies. Those are some hot dead bodies. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Princess reference. I don't know if you guys have ever seen Princess. Careful Googling or searching Princess on YouTube. It is not safe for work. But it's funny if you like that sort of shit. Okay. Regulator. I don't even know what a regulator is. All right. Turrets at the front. Dealt with. Interesting that none of these mercs could figure that out. Just stand behind the fence posts. No. Okay. All right. Head over here. Raise plates on the ground. There we are. Okay, I believe this door is trapped. Not much I can do about it. I just gotta take damage. There it goes. Oh, locked. Ooh. First pick. I got it. What? I can't carry that much. All right, I'm gonna be back here. Yeah, that's why. That's how it's your shell weighs 40 pounds. All right, I got a sneeze coming up any second now. So if you see the cut, that's what it is. Here it comes. All right, post sneeze. We're back. All right. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. There are raised plates right there. Ooh. Oh, come on. Idiot. Sometimes the pathing in this game is a bit of a pain in the ass. Like, right there. Alright. Alright, let's load this howitzer shell. And let's press the button. See what happens. Front door is open. Hey, if you guys will see over here, there's plenty of howitzers over here. Uncle Wright will be happy once he gets his hands on this place. This fucking thing. Die, die, die. Go down here real quick and I'm going to turn the backup. Or I'm gonna. What does it do exactly? Okay, yeah. So I cut the power to the whole base, and the backup generators kick on. So that's basically going to turn all the force fields inside from yellow, which is impassable, to red, which means you can pass through it but take damage. And that's really to just avoid spamming my repair skill, or rather Vic's repair skill, at the terminals. These things right here are a little harder to sneak past. In fact, you can't sneak past. Yeah. I'm probably fucked. Yep, I'm fucked. Yep, okay. So, finding a way to... Come on. Jesus. Finding a fence post, I guess, stand behind for these guys is not quite as easy. Although, shit, I can go over here, I think. I never done this before. Here. Nice. I've never done it this way before. Alright, awesome. Using the limited environment of old school games to take advantage of combat. What do we call that? Is that cheating? I feel like that's not cheating. It's just... I mean, to fight these turrets straight up is... I mean, you guys have seen. It's fucking suicide. So, I'm going to work around it however I can. Yeah, because otherwise I'm trying to think of when... Like, you'd have to come back and power armor minimum to be able to straight up try and fight these turrets. They do a lot of damage. Oh yeah, you end up having to just play this hit and hide game. There we go. All right. External turrets dealt with. Let's head back over here into this building. There are a few more things we could loot. You guys will probably remember we saw a rocket launcher among one of them. Yep, rocket launcher. Ammo. More ammo. Alright, so this container right here is also... It's trapped and... Oh, I got it. And now, yeah, there we go. It's like trapped and locked, and it's just, it's a pain in the ass, but no worries, we'll take the damage. We can rest it off later. Okay. So, yeah. We have just successfully breached the Sierra Army Depot. So I'm going to go get my companions, and we're going to go head inside, see what we find. Come on, fat man. Fat man.
What do you want?
Marky Mark.
You want me back?
A boy, Sulik.
What you been?
And old man Cass.
What's up?
What's up, you, bro?
Alright then.
Alright then. Yeah, alright.
Okay, in we go to the Sierra Army Depot, number 6. That means there's 5 other ones out there, at least. Cool. Oh, I can't rest in here, that's sad. Alright, oh, there's a password on there. You'll forgive me if I move through this rather, relatively quickly. Again, this is not the first time I've done this. Not at all. Alright, we got some holotapes in here, I think. Yes, we do. I like to put holotapes back once I read them. There's sort of no point carrying them around. All right. 2077, July 9th. Sierra Army Depot evacuated. Cool. All right, let's hit the password. Dick Gatowski. Boom. Open. Doing some stuff. Oh no. Right. Stuff. I'm wondering where I put the strength module. I think it's in the Sulix carrier or it's in the car. But yeah, right here. This is the yellow memory module, which I believe is for perception or intelligence. Intelligence. There we go. So, much later in the game, when we get to the little Brotherhood area, we'll be able to use that. Let's see if Sulu's carrying it, actually. I don't think he is. Oh, he is. Okay, I'm going to take that back just so I have everything I need with me. All right. So you'll see that we picked up that eye. I'll show you what we do with it in a moment. Just gonna clear out the rest of this place. For whatever reason, I'm not sure why, but these punching bags will actually level up your unarmed skill a little bit. Yeah, 5% each. Which, yeah, it's pretty, you know, 10% right there if you use both. Alright, let's get to looting. Ah. Ooh, hello. Oh, can't carry them. Alright. Okay, who's got enough space? I don't even know anymore. I'm always tentative to give the rocket launcher to Marcus, and where he's gonna swap it out, and then next thing I know, everyone's dead. I'll give that to Cass. Right. Back for that. And I'll show you guys why I came here with no armor. It's because, boom! Combat armor. First real big, first, next tier of gear. I would say like the first tier is like leather armor, metal armor, and then the next is the Mark IIs. And then combat armor is really when you start to hit. Once you get combat armor, you know you're towards the middle of the game, approaching end game. It's definitely got the best statistics for pretty much everything, so far at least. Okay, so this eye right here belongs to Corporal Dixon. And it probably took me like 4 or 5 playthroughs to realize that this retinal scanner, if you use the eye, boom, down we go. Oh boy. All right, now here's where companions start to start to hate me. oh, sorry guys. This floor is the, I should save it right here. This floor is really one of the best, the room that you're looking to loot. Guys, I'm not Chinese, I don't know why I'm doing that, I apologize. Alright. Disable shock plates. Disable force fields. All right, so you can. Oh, don't go in there, Vic. Don't go in there. Don't go in there. Don't go in there. Don't go. Mark. Oh boy. Yeah, that room. That room will fuck you up if you start wandering around in there. Okay. I am going to... Let's see. And I get... Okay. With the electronic lockpick and a lockpick of 45, I should be able to get these doors down right here, which will give me access to that room, which has a bunch of goodies inside. And yeah, you guys have probably noticed all these robots are ignoring me. If they were not, I would be in huge, huge trouble. Come on. Hit it. Oh, no. That's not at all what I wanted. Okay. All right, let's try this one more time. Oh, really? Come on. All right, we're gonna go, we're gonna go back upstairs and try and come down the way I used to come down. We're gonna try and go come down this way. Because that room is filled with a bunch of goodies. Come on. RN Jesus. Deliver me unto a good roll. Ugh. It's just too low, it seems. It says I jammed it. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. No! Oh, man. I'm gonna try and dump these 4 points into lockpick. See if that's enough to get this door open. Oh wow, really? Okay, so these doors. Are wanting a much higher. Lockpick check. All right, unfortunately, it looks like we're gonna have to kind of ignore this room down here, which is I don't like it, because inside there are some really cool shit. I can get the shock plates down. Is there a password for the shock plates? What does that do? Really debating what to do here. I might be able to actually make it into this room and loot what I need.
What you be needing?
With, just by running across the shock plates and healing every step. But, yeah. You know what? Let's try it. Been a while.
Want to take a little?
What's up?
I don't think I've ever actually done it this way, so it'll be interesting to find out how worth it is.
What do you want? I'll just...
Right. Let's fucking give it a shot. Oof. This will probably end up costing us 20 or so stim packs, but I don't want to say it can't live without, but I think there's like two pieces of combat armor in here that, you know, obviously will come in quite a bit in handy for our party. Ouch. Okay, I made it through. Alright. Let's get what we need. Not what we want. See, like, you know, those rocket launchers, we'll come back for them when I level up a little more. My science and whatnot. But, ooh, plasma rifle, too. But, where you at, combat armor? You in here? There you are. Fuck. Alright, what do I gotta lose? What do I gotta ditch? Alright, how much do I have to ditch? I gotta lose 10 pounds. Fuck! Okay. I can actually, I think I can just put these microfusion cells in here. I don't really need them right now in the game. Alright, looks like that's going to be it. Okay, when we come back with a higher either lockpick or science skill, we'll be able to disable these. There's no like super sledge in here, is there? I can't remember. No, assault rifles. Sniper rifle. Machine gun? No, I don't think so.
No, 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 no.
All right, so in 100 hours when we come back... Ooh, I can pick that shit up, though. Okay. In 100 hours when we come back... Just kidding, it'll probably be like 20. But, yeah, we'll be able to fully loot this room. But this is really the most important things that I need from here. And given that I have, you know, 82 and counting stim packs, it's worth the... The damage, in my opinion. Yeah, it's probably... What did I start with? I probably started with 90 or so. So I'm going to finish with a little 70 or under. Worth it? Worth 20 stim packs? I think so. Especially given how rare I use... Rarely I use stim packs. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. Cool.
What you be?
So, unlike a lot of other modern RPGs, if you tell your companions to wait somewhere, that's where they're waiting. So, if I were to have somehow like picked that door and then left that way, my companions would still be here. All right, we're gonna sprint to this open door. Although, actually, let's go down. Let's give you that.
What you be needing?
What you be needing? All right, upgrade to the Sulik, and then Cass, I think, is gonna get the other one. He's usually a little closer to the front of combat than I am.
You got that I'm pulling rank look again.
All right. Ooh, you're nice and encumbered now. Let's take these off you. I can carry them now. Now that I'm not carrying two fucking things of power or combat armor. Okay. Go down to level 3. Okay. Rest? No, not yet. All right. Again, I'm gonna have my companions just wait here. They're hurting pretty bad.
I'll just.
So.
What you be?
I'd rather.
We be.
I'd rather just rest it out. And
What's up?
I'd rather just rest it out than waste healing supplies on them. Those healing supplies that they carry are meant more for oh shit combat scenarios. Few more. We're definitely not going to complete the Sierra Army Depot right now. You need quite a high science skill to get Skynet. I don't know if that name rings a bell to you guys, but from the Terminator series. But yeah, you can actually acquire Skynet as a companion in this game. But to do so, yeah, you need a very big. I think you need a science skill of like 120 or something like that. Which, I mean, yeah, Skynet's one of those interesting characters. Like, he's really good if you're going like evil, because a lot of your really good, powerful companions don't follow you if you go bad path. Yeah. All right. Oh, and if you notice, I picked up from there. Clifton's Eye. Clifton's Eye will allow us to go down to the fourth level. Which we're not going to go to right now. We'll save that for later. Do I want to loot that room? I guess I do. That shit will come in a lot more handy for me right now than it will later in the game. Oh shit. Okay, Vic. So, also, when you tell your companions to wait, they are no longer technically flagged as an ally. You guys. Oh, okay. They still have the green thing. But, like, right there, see how I got experience for stealing from Vic, or rather, planting shit on Vic? If he had caught me right there, we would have gone into combat, and it would have been no bueno. Alright. And also, I know I have a bunch of books. Part of the reason I'm not using them right now is there. I don't know if it's a bug or if it's intentional. But if Vic is injured and I don't know if it's a time thing or if it's just a bug. I've had one playthrough where Vic just like turns into he like kind of turns against you. It's really weird. Like he's still following you, but like you can't talk to him, and he's like, "I've had enough," and. Yeah, so I'm trying to avoid having him take too much more damage right now. I'm trying to get to a place where we can rest and heal up, or to avoid that scenario of cranky Vic.
What do you want?
You want me back now?
You want me back now?
Guys, get the fuck out of the way. Alright. So we're gonna get out of here now. And then yeah, we'll come back when our stats are in such a way that we can benefit from what we have done here today. Or rather, when we can Vic is overloaded. That's no fun. Alright, can we rest here? Yes we can. Awesome. Okay. I'm gonna take a little break while you rest. I'll talk to you all in a bit. Okay, we are back after resting. Everyone's happy. Oh, Vic's overloaded, but other than that, he should be good. And yeah, we're gonna head back to New Reno now. Let me just see how overloaded Vic is. How you doing? Oh, that was the wrong button. Combat control. 20 pounds. All right. Well, looks like you're going to be 20 pounds overweight for a little bit, Vicky. I got the... I don't think I got that spare. Nope, I don't. Okay. All right. Back to New Reno we go. All right, let's stop on Virgin Street. All right, gonna do a little more inventory management because of course I am. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I am back after doing some quick inventory management. Okay. So there's sort of a dilemma we run into at this point in the game. If we go get made by the Wrights, without having power armor on, the game actually does not like us. Or rather, if you run into, say I'm a made man of the Wrights, right? And I run into here, Desperado. They start shooting at me. They tell me to get lost because I'm a made man of another family. Which is cool. I really like the flavor. But it, makes completing a few quests difficult. Let's see here. Okay. You know what though? I think I'm gonna do it. And then if they got a problem with it, they'll have a problem with it and we'll fight. And that might be, you know, that's something I actually haven't tested in a while. So maybe the restoration project changed that, but go find out. Because yeah, becoming a made man at this point. Forgive that. I think it was a truck just drove by. Becoming a made man at this point in the game is pretty useful. It opens up. Eldridge's special stock, which is going to have some really, really sweet things inside. Alright. Ah, you. You got some good news for me? You find a way into that army base? Yes, I managed to get inside and found a lot of old weapons and military hardware. It's all there for the taking. Now, about my payment. Eyes gleam. You done good, Porto. Go to the cat's paw in New Reno Arms. Tell them you're from me and they'll set you up. You're a family man now. A made man. And all New Reno's going to know it. Thanks, Mr. Wright. If I'm a made man, then I like to be called... What do I like? What do I like to be called? Lumpy. Ace? Do I like Ace? I think Ace is my favorite. Little Joe. Okay. Alright, we're gonna go with Ace. I don't know why. Ace. I like it. It's got style. Now you stop on by the cat's paw in your Reno Arms and they'll take care of you. You need free hooch? Head on by the train station too. I'll set you up. Thanks, I'll do that. Okay, so we have become a made man of the Wright family. Boom. Right there. So yeah, that unlocks a couple things. I'll go show you right now. We'll head back to Virgin Street. We'll get everybody laid first. All right, we are back here. Back here on Virgin Street. Head to the cat's paw, right? That's what he said. The woman before you is stunningly beautiful. As you address her, she looks up from her work and smiles. Ah, a new face. I'm Miss Kitty. Welcome to the Cat's Paw. What's your pleasure today, sir? You know, I've been finding magazines named Cat's Paw throughout the desert, and I have no idea what they are. Got one right here. Look surprised. Let me see. Well, you know, I hear a rumor that in the pre-war years, the Cat's Paw was a publishing house for pornographic materials. This place was a publishing house? Yes, the rooms here are used for film shoots with models from across the world. Seems entranced by the magazine. Quite a little piece of history you have here. I'm just glad to know that what the damn thing. I'm just glad to know what the damn thing is. It's irritating to keep examining it and getting that message over and over again. I'll probably still get it even though it's identified now. You know, you can bring me a complete set, say 10, and I'll buy them from you. They'd be good for display. Might attract customers. Are you interested? If I can find that many, say. I had some other questions. Jules told me to come by. Is that so? Okay. Ask you some questions. I'd like to hook up one of my friends here. It's their birthday. Vic. Traitor Vic. Is your friend here? Looks your companion up and down. I think we can accommodate that. Don't worry, there's no charge. Can't argue with the price. Alright, so yeah. Being a made man of right lets you get laid for free. Cassidy here. I think it's been a while. Go on, Cass. Goddamn champion. Alright, my friend. Bono is here if you catch my drift. Alright. Anyone can handle Marcus? No charge for Marcus. Nice. Okay. Alright, I want some action. I have a special, dramatic request. I'd like to be captured by some ravishing she-mood and then be forced to take a dip in her mutating vat. God. Boom. Alright, so everybody got laid. Don't worry, we'll take care of you guys too later. Oh, and I'm no longer a virgin. That's nice. It's sad to think that even at 27, living in a tribal village, he would still be a virgin, but virgin of the wastes, I guess. Okay. Alright, let's go talk to our old boy, Eldridge. Actually, before we do that, let's run into the Mordino Casino over here and see what happens. Let's see what happens. Yep, okay. So, until I come back in power armor, I am not going to be able to complete the quests at Mordino and Bishop. Which is also fine, because... Yeah, you'll see later. I'm gonna end up wiping them out. It'll be great. Alright. Let's go open up Eldridge's special stock. And if it does open up, I need to be prepared with shit to sell. Okie dokie. My boss, Wright, told me to stop by that you would set me up. Eldridge looks at you and down. His tone becomes more respectful. Sure, of course. Let me show you our special stock. At a discount, of course. Super sludge. No! That's too bad. There's a Bozar in here, which is arguably the most powerful gun in the game. But I can get one for free much later on. And I'm nowhere near being able to use or even needing to use it. So I will let that go. His stock actually rotates. So sometimes if you come back and talk to him a few times, it'll rotate through some bigger guns. But it does not look like he's going to have what I'm looking for. Nope. Okay. I'm looking for the super sledge for Sulik. That's his endgame weapon. It is on Eldridge's special stock loot table, but it's sort of just a matter of luck of if you get it or not, and we were not that lucky. Which is okay. No biggie. But yeah, so the Bozar later in the game is your end game weapon, if you're going a sniper build at least. So pretty much the rest of the game, it's not a bad idea to hoard 223 ammo where you can. I don't need... Okie dokie dokie. to 66. Alright, gonna do... I know, right? More inventory management. Fuck me. Just gonna go talk to Algernon, get him to upgrade some weapons, and then we're going to be heading out of here, I think. So, I might make a cut here, not sure. But if you see one, yeah, we'll see you back in a couple minutes. Once I'm done with all the weapon upgrading I'm looking to do. Alright guys, we're back after a little break. Just did a little inventory management, because that's the name of this game. Now I'm going to go do some, although I got to do more because Vic is all overloaded and shit. But I'm just going to go do some upgrading with Algy over here. Everything. Bunch of assault rifles, plasma rifle, laser pistols. Ooh, I'm overloaded now. Fun. Alright, oh yeah, and you'll see right here, I got me a turbocharged plasma rifle. One of the, it's probably the best sniper rifle in the game. The laser rifle does more damage, or excuse me, the laser rifle has a better range, quite a bit better range, but the plasma rifle just straight up does more damage and still has excellent range. So that's what we get to very end game, that's what we end up going around with. At least that's what I do. I go around with a Bozar turbo plasma rifle combo. All right, cool guys. As you see, I've swapped up some of my weapons. I'm going to be now playing with this expanded magazine assault rifle and then this sniper rifle. We're pretty much fully into our sniper light build with some unarmed along with it. So yeah, that's probably going to end up being how we play the rest of the game. There is still some use for the 10mm JHP once we get the HNK P90. But that'll be in the next episode, most likely. So then we'll get some, we can just spam 10mm downrange for the rest of the game with that. But, I think we're going to stop it there. It's another hour and a half playthrough, I believe. So, New Reno is pretty, well, Tier 1 New Reno is done. We're going to come back, and we still got Weston to deal with either way. And we still have, got to go talk to the Mordinos about killing Salvatore. We might not be able to step in those casinos again until we're in advanced power armor, which, or actually power armor in general, which is a really cool thing they did. That if you walk in power armor, even though you're a made man of another family, no one will fuck with you because you're terrifying looking. That's tier 2 New Reno. Tier 2 New Reno also involves me coming back and pretty much killing all the families and running New Reno as I see fit. That's more of a role, from a role playing perspective for me. You don't actually become anointed as King of New Reno, but that's the way I see it. So thanks for watching, guys. This has been Angry Porto, a.k.a. Clancy, a.k.a. Take It Slow, a.k.a. Too Many Goddamn Nicknames. And I will catch you all next time on the Fallout 2 20th Anniversary playthrough. Thanks for watching.
Take It Slow.